Now that we have configured a scheduled task to perform an automated daily backup of our PyData archive to a dedicated drive on our PyData archive machine, there's only one more thing we have to do for our backup plan. Even though we have our backups currently being stored on a dedicated disk drive, this will only protect them against hardware failure on either the disk drive that holds our PyData archive or our archive files. What would happen if we lost the entire PyData archive machine itself? For this reason, in addition to our automated backups on our separate drive on our PyData archive machine, we should also take a backup of our backup directory and store it on another remote medium. This should be entirely separate from our PyData archive machine. Again, this is to allow for data recovery if the entire PyData archive machine is lost. Additionally, on a remote directory, we can create a backup repository or a collection of various backups at different restore points. To show you what that would look like, I'm going to navigate to another machine called K-Holstein Back, which is a machine solely for my backups. Here you can see I have a collection of various PyData archive backups on different dates. You may be wondering why this is advantageous. Well, consider the following. What if you discover a configuration issue 2 weeks after the fact? You've been taking your automated daily backups on your PyData archive, however, it always goes to the same backup directory. Therefore, you do not have a backup from before the configuration change occurred 2 weeks prior. On the other hand, if you have a backup repository, such as that shown here, you would be able to find a backup from 3 weeks prior that you could use to restore your PyData archive's configuration, as the backup is from before the configuration change happened. As you can see, within each of these files is a full backup of my PyData archive from the date specified in the directory itself. Please note that it is recommended that you use a third-party backup tool to accomplish this as part of your IT's backup process. Thus, you should check with your IT department first and see if they have a third-party tool available to help copy your local backup directory from your PyData archive to a remote location. However, if your IT department is unable to assist you with this, you can use the same pisitebackup.bat script that we saw in the previous video, which helped us include our PyPC directories in our automated daily backups. So let's take a look at what that entails. If I navigate back to my PyData archive machine, which in my case is KBH PySRV, I'm going to open up Notepad and select to run it as an administrator. Then I can open the pisitebackup.bat script that we looked at in the previous video. This is in my PyData archive installation directory, which by default is C program files py within the ADM folder. And right now it's a batch file. So if I change to all file types and find my pisitebackup.bat. Once I open this within Notepad, you can see the instructions for the script itself. Again, we performed task one in the previous video, which was to include our PyPC directories in our automated daily backup. So now we're going to focus on how to perform task two, which is to backup our intermediate backup directory to a remote location. For task two, there are two different types of remote backups that we can do. One is to take a full copy of our backup directory each time the scheduled task runs and append the date of that backup. This can be used to create the backup repository that I just showed you on my other machine with different restore points for your PyData archive. The other option is to copy our backup directory to the same directory every time. However, this will only keep one backup and thus not allow us to restore from an older backup if necessary. In order to perform the two different types of backups for task two, we will use either UNC path 1 or UNC path 2 to set our remote backup directory location. So if we select UNC path 1, it will call the backup routine backup the backup example 1, versus UNC path 2 will call backup the backup example 2. If I take a look further down below, I can find the particular subroutine. So in this case, I found backup the backup example 1. And again, this copies our entire PyData archive backup directory to a new directory on a remote location each time the scheduled task runs. This will place it in a subfolder for the computer name and then the date that the backup is run. Therefore, this is used to create a repository of our PyData archive backups. If I do not want to store a new copy of my backup every time, I can use backup the backup example 2, which in this, as you can see here, it copies our backup directory to the same remote location every time. And therefore, we will only have one copy of our backup directory available on a remote node in the event that our entire PyData Archive machine is lost. Since I'd like to create a repository of my PyData Archive backups, I'm going to use backup the backup example 1 and therefore set my UNC path 1. Before I can set my remote directory, I have to choose a location where I'd like to store these backups remotely, as well as ensure that the user running my automated daily backup task has access to the remote directory and the ability to write in that location. Therefore, first I'm going to open up the Windows Task Scheduler on my PyData Archive machine and take a look at my automated scheduled task for my PyData Archive backups. Within the Task Scheduler library, I can see my PyData Archive backup. If I double click on it, it will let me edit its configuration. By default, it runs as your local system account. However, since I need the user running my automated backup to have access to the remote directory, I'm going to change this to a domain account. You can either select a service account that you've created, or in my case, I'll just use my domain account as I know it has access to the remote directory I'm going to specify. Similarly, I'm going to select to run with the highest privileges as it's my administrative abilities that will give me access to my remote directory. Once I select OK, it will prompt me for the credentials of that account. And now I can see that I've successfully changed the user that will run my automated task. In order to confirm that my user has access to the remote directory, I'm going to navigate to my remote machine. Again, in my case, this is my backup machine. Here, I have a dedicated drive for my remote Pi backups, and this is where I'm going to store my backups. If I right-click on the directory I'd like to place my backups and select Properties, I can confirm that within Security, the account that I specified to run my scheduled task will have the ability to access and write to this remote directory. Now that I've confirmed that this user can access the remote directory, I'll navigate back to my Pi Data Archive machine and return to the notepad where we have the PySite backup script open. Now I can set the UNC path for my remote backup directory by removing the REM from the line to uncomment it, and then specifying the computer name, which in my case is K Holstein Back, and then the directory I'd like. So for me, this is on my E drive in a folder called PyBackups. Once I select Save, I can close the pisitebackup.bat script, and we can go test this now. If I open up my task scheduler, I can choose to run my automated backup task now. And because we've specified the UNC path for our remote backup location, it will be included in the scheduled task. So once I select Run, I can choose to display all running tasks to watch the current status of my automated task. Once my scheduled task has disappeared from my running tasks list, I'm going to go and check the remote directory that we specified for my remote backups. Therefore, I'm going to navigate back to my backup machine. And within the location I specified, which was my E drive, Pi Backups, I can see that a directory was created with the name of my Pi Data Archive. Within that, there was another folder created with the date that the automated task ran on. And finally, within that, I can see the backup of my PyData Archive was copied to this remote directory. Now, not only will my data be safe in the case of hardware failure on the drive that holds my PyData Archive or my archive files themselves, but now I'm protected against an entire machine failure for my PyData Archive since I have my backups copied to a remote location. Now that we have our full backup procedure in place, we can talk about how to monitor and check the status of your backups in the next video.